Hi, welcome to Uber Micro Repairs. On the Healing Bench today we have something else that isn't broken. This is a SCUF and it's in perfect working order. In fact, it's one from our stock that has been fully refurbished and is actually ready for sale. But what I'm going to do to it is install some brand new analogues. These are quite special. These are specifically designed for PS4 controllers. For anyone playing along at home, you've probably guessed what they are. These are Hall Effect analogues. This is what everyone's been after for years and years, thinking that they are going to be the end of stick drift. I'll tell you right now, Hall Effect sensors will not stop stick drift. They will definitely help to keep it at bay for as long as possible, but it won't be the potentiometers that fail. It will actually be the spring back actually inside the mechanism that actually brings the stick back to centre. Just for use, that will wear out, and the snap or the spring will actually wear out and get looser, and that will induce some type of drift like qualities. Although everyone says that Hall Effect sensors will eliminate stick drift, unfortunately they will never eliminate wear and tear on the stick. So these are a magic wand fix, but they're not the be all or end all. Anyway, let's get this unboxed, get it open, take out the brand new analogues that I originally put in this a couple of weeks ago, and replace them with brand new Hall Effect sensors. So let's get on with that. Here's the controller. We have brand new caps on here. One of them's got an indent, one of them's domed, and they are a bit longer than the standard. This is one of our refurbished controllers. This was stock on our for our website. Let's get these under the microscope and just have a look and see what's going on. And there we go. So we've got the Hall Effect sensors, which are marked right and left. For some reason, the middle bit here, which in this orientation would make the left and right pop move, these two pieces here are a lot thicker than a standard analog. If I grab one and do a comparison, see left and right there. Sorry, it is black on black. So you can see the thickness of these are a lot thinner on the standard Alps, and these ones are really thick, which is good. And if we unclip one of these, there's the little magnet. And inside we just have a Hall Effect sensor, and the marking on the IC is 49331. There is no information on that IC on Google or anywhere else. Cannot find any info on that. And to get these centered, if we look down these tiny holes here and here, when we move it left and right, you can see the magnet inside move. So in order to center it, you move the stick over to one side, you get something thin, push it in the hole, see how the stick isn't returning to center, then you just sort of move it left or right depending on the side that is drifting. To get it centered, but all of that will be shown a bit later on in the video. But overall, there's no center slop in that stick. That's really nice and fluid. They do feel like really good quality sticks. Let's get this SCUF apart, get the sticks put in, and you guys know the drill, I'll speed run it. Hall effect analogs are installed, nice and clean, all the pads are good. Now that the analogs are installed, let's get this on the tester and get them centered. Here they are, installed. As you can see, we're about 5% out in the lower left quadrant on each stick. That's okay, no worries at all. So, as we saw earlier, we use these small holes. Okay, that's left and right pretty much centered on the left stick. Let's do the up and down. Close. Okay, we still need a bit more. There we go, centering into within. And they are a little bit jittery, but don't worry about that at all. The PlayStation console will actually filter that out during play. It's not uncommon for the to jitter slightly, even for regular analogs. There we go, left one done. Let's go move over to the right one. So we'll do the up and down on the right, and currently it's down. I do have it upside down, that's just easier for me to hold. And there we have it, we have them centered really well. Up and down could probably be a little bit better on the right one. Okay, there we go. I'd say they're pretty much as good as they're gonna be. Yep, happy with that. Let's get this stuffed back in the shell and see how they perform. okay, here's the moment of truth. Are these analogs any good? So we are centered. They do have a little bit of a shimmering jitter to them, but again, I'm not worried about that. Standard analogs can do that, and also some of that gets filtered out from the PlayStation anyway, so don't worry too much. Do we get 100% all around the clock? 100, 100, 100, 100. Wow. 100, 100, 100, 100. Whee! There we go. We have a SCUF Infinity PRO upgraded with Hall Effect analog sticks. How cool is that? To the L3 R3 pushdown, it's got a slightly, nicer action compared to an Alps. Alps is usually quite stiff and clunky. These just feel a little bit more plush. Pushing it down when you're at extremes seems to be a lot easier. Yeah, I like them. They're good. And the centering, 100% all around the clock. Cool. And just to show you there's no funny business going on, there he is. Cool. And there we have it. I think that will pretty much conclude this video. So I think this has been quite an interesting video. This works absolutely spot on, as you can see. So if you would like a upgrade service to a PS4 standard controller or a PS4 SCUF controller, please get in contact. The details are in the description below. And as always, I hope you enjoyed the video and take care.